Tajikistan is famous for the Pamir Highway. The Pamir Highway lies mainly between Osh in Kyrgyzstan and Dushanbe in Tajikistan. The road is heavily damaged by erosion, earthquakes, landslides, etc. It's known as the second highest altitude international highway. It's the only continuous route through the difficult terrain of the mountains, part of the Silk Road. These days famous for cyclists, van dwellers like me, 4x4 tours and an occasional hitchhiker. I drove from Osh to Dushanbe. The border crossing into Tajikistan is easy. You pay $25 for your car and I paid $10 for import taxes and $10 for my puppy dog. The visa is an online visa which costs $70. Just know that your car gets only a 15-day visa, so you have to extend that. The e-visa is 45 days. If you're doing the trip by your own van, it's recommendable to be self-sufficient. My van broke down 3 times and there were not many people around to help me, especially when I hit a rock going off-road. You don't need a 4x4 high on its wheels necessarily, but if you don't have one, you will have to skip a few spots, like these ones off-road after Murghab, the Geyser, these ruins, and this stone circle. You have to get through pretty deep water to reach any of these. Tajikistan is all about visiting nature and going off-road. Khorog is the first bigger town I arrived to with a bazaar and car garages. It's also the first city 650 km away from Osh that sells diesel. After Khorog, I drove to Ishkashim along the Afghanistan border. On the way are the Garm Chasma hot springs, which are really hot. And it's a nude hot spring, so I couldn't film there. In Ishkashim used to be a Saturday market between Afghanistan and Tajikistan, where both cultures would meet. This market has been closed for the last months. Khorog used to have the Sunday Afghanistan markets, but also this one has been closed for the last months. Further down is the Hulberg Castle, a famous castle from the Silk Road time. You can continue right or left to Dushanbe. Right goes along the Nurek Dam, left goes along Sarbat. Sarbat is a beautiful nature reserve. You can walk over a dried out river along beautiful rocky mountains. Then you arrive in Dushanbe. Dushanbe is nothing like the rest of Tajikistan. It's a very clean big city where people are well dressed. Everything you need you can find in Dushanbe. Even though this might be the end of the Pamir Highway, on the road towards Uzbekistan are some more beauties to be found. There is the Guzgarv waterfall, which was dry when I was there, but still the hike was beautiful. A little bit further is Lake Iskander Kul. Not too far away is the Yaknob Valley. Several towns where inhabitants of Tajikistan have survived many invasions decades ago. About an hour further on the highway are the Alauddin Lakes, 3 gorgeous lakes. Guest houses outside of the city can be very expensive for no obvious reason. Food is cheap. It might take a while before you get to a new place, so better stock up for a few days of food. You can only withdraw money from an ATM in big cities like Khorog and Dushanbe. There are money exchange offices on the way. Visa works well, Maestro only at the Kaskomer Bank. Better take some dollars with you. I really enjoyed Tajikistan. Compared to Kyrgyzstan, Tajikistan has less small cities with facilities and less public transport. The people in Tajikistan are extremely friendly and welcoming. Almost everyone tried to invite me for tea and bread. I think it's a country well worth visiting, especially if you're already in Central Asia.